Castle Street, Dunedin, the home of the Scarfy dream. And this is number 662, which I spent the whole year of 2007 living in. But what's so special about your old flat, Tony? Well, the neighbours. 660 Castle Street, home of the band of the very same name, achieving massive success with number ones as far as the eye can see, selling out Western Springs twice and now their very own movie. They're basically the biggest band New Zealand has ever seen, and they've bloody turned up to meet me. So we're outside the place where it all happened. Machu, you lived here. Talk us through the memories you have when you come back here.
It was kind of chaos, my memories of this street.
Yeah.
It kind of was just this like self-contained little kind of student ghetto. And there were couch burnings. There was always like one drunk person strolling around the street.
Yeah.
But, you know, this is the beating heart of the band and where it really started. And then we really cut our teeth up in that room. Our first ever performance was in that room.
And did you guys used to be called 660 Jams, is that right?
We've had a few names,
yeah.
And it kind of evolved over the time, but essentially, because we played here, and this is where people would come to see on, you know, between, from the Guardies, I'd stop in and hit, and would play, and then would go on to the Cook, we essentially became known as the 660 Boys, and that's, so basically, we got our name from our very early fans.
Can you say any of the other options that were floated around?
My favourite? You want to hear my favourite?
Yeah.
My favourite was 3MG. And that's 3 Maoris and a ginger.
Right.
Yeah.
That is...
I don't know why we didn't stick with that one.
Yeah, it's a winner, that one.
It is a winner.
When did you make that transition from just like a couple of guys having a sing and then being like, we're actually a band?
I think when we were in our last year here, we basically felt and knew that we were going to split up because we were going to leave university and that would be the end of the group. We were going to go pursue whatever other careers we were going to find. And we said that we'll have a go at writing some material, you know, it's kind of basically like a remembrance of our time here and being together. The same vibe we were trying to create in that tiny room to 10 people is the same thing we're trying to do to 50,000 at Western Springs. And over the time, I guess we've gotten a little bit better and more refined at it and don't drink as much and better at our instruments and stuff. But honestly, the philosophy is still the same. And so we're really indebted to this city and our time here. I don't know if it would have happened if it wasn't for Dunedin and our time down here.
Yeah, and it is a hell of a story. Obviously, the movie, the premiere is in Dunedin tonight. You were at a premiere last night. How is it seeing yourself on the big screen?
Yeah, I hate it. Can't see. I might slip out the back tonight, so I don't have to watch it. But it is what it is. And yeah, I think people... From what I heard about last night, people really enjoyed it. So
one of the things the movie has done is kind of allowed us to actually reflect and celebrate the mahi that's been put in and our friendship. Stoked. We've got a movie.
You got a movie. I know. Movie stars legit. You went from this flat to a movie screen. And lastly, guys, big night tonight, obviously. The movie premiere down there. You excited about it? How are you feeling?
Yeah, good. Feeling good about watching the movie for the 20th time.
Awesome, man. We'll enjoy it. I'm sure the crowd will, and I will too, and I appreciate your time.
Thank you.
Hanging out outside the beating heart of 660, where it all began.
Beautiful. All its glory.
All its glory. Don't forget your roots, my friend, yeah.